I hope you guys are as excited about the Raptor 61 as I am. I got to design my own telescope that doesn't feel pure and real. It is 100% pure, overpriced, and I'll feel partly responsible for that. I apologize. Because astrophotography is too important to sell.
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 This isn't a scientific experiment by any means. It's just kind of a fun way to look at the same telescopes. You'll see how the same telescopes can look completely different depending on the style, the name, the packaging. But they're not that different, so not exactly a head-to-head matchup. But I think it'll be super interesting to see the results on the same target.
Very cool. So obviously this video is just going to pick up a lot of really interesting, deep details on this telescopes.
But it's something you need to think about when investing in a new telescope. You really want to look into that interesting details. You want to know what you can expect. I think throughout life, we all experience moments of inspiration and creativity. And in these moments, we can do the kind of stuff that other people can feel too.
Hello and welcome along to this video. At first, I want to point out that everything I'm saying here is my own opinion. It expresses my view to my best knowledge. There might be some other opinions on some of the points I will make, but all I can present to you is my honest opinion based on my knowledge. And I'm quite sure that I will present you good reasons and somehow kind of evidence that will convince you. Second, I produced this video under the law of free speech and education. I used some snippets of other videos under the law of education and the right to quote. If you feel attacked or misrepresented, feel free to contact me. This video isn't short, but if you're patient, you will discover many little but important details, have a lot of good laughs and a satisfying amount of bittersweet irony. I'm sure most of you will not regret to watch every single minute. So be curious and make you ready for nearly 1 hour of detailed deconstructions. The statements I will make are based on two kinds of sources. The first sources are two videos which refer to the Radian Raptor. One by Trevor, Astro Backyard, where he is presenting his telescope.
I got to design my own telescope.
The other by OPT, where they present the Raptor.
Let's take a look inside this epic experience.
I use the term presenting, although it would be way more correct to call it advertise with exaggerations and false statements, which almost border to straight lies. The second base for my statements is the Radian Raptor itself, of course. I own this telescope and I have used and compared it for quite some nights, so I know what I'm talking about. And I can tell you straight away, it's quite a good telescope. Not outstanding or unique by any means, but a solid good telescope. Extremely overpriced, but with a fair and good image quality, as you would expect by a telescope produced by a company that has lots of experience doing this and compared to other telescopes built by them. But I'm not here to talk about good image quality, and you're not here to listen on that. I guessed that you are here because, well, you read the title and might have thought, wow, that's a claim. How will he prove? So feel free to join me as I will bring you that proof bit by bit. Ready? Then let's start.
And today we're going to be talking about charging handles, but specifically we're going to be talking about the Radian Raptor lineup. Now, the Radian Raptor is by far my favorite ambidextrous charging handle. You can go back in my videos and see for years the different ones that I've used for AR-15s and AR-10 builds. I think they're fantastic. So here we have the original Raptor, but they just added a brand new one.
This is the Radian Raptor 61.
The first thing you might want to know is, who or which company is producing the Radian Raptor? When you Google it, you will find an US-based weapon company called Radian. This company is producing a tool for many years now, a tool called the Radian Raptor.
I got to design my own telescope.
I design, and of course, the name.
I have no clue about weapons, besides that optical gun I point to stars to shoot nebula and galaxies. But as far as I understand, this tool helps the user to reload or recharge an automatic weapon faster. It kind of remembers me somehow on an accessory you will need to climb an icefall. But as said, I have no clue on weapons. But you might already have noticed, this is not the company which is fabricating the Radian Raptor. Or yes, they are, but it's a different Radian Raptor.
I got to design my own Radian Raptor, and it needs to be all black, but not shiny black, like a matte black, with red accents, like one of those Canon L-series lenses.
So the company that produces the Radian Raptor is called OPT, right? No, it's not OPT. They are just selling it and printed the name on it. I'm sure for 99% that the company is called Trevor Optical Instruments. And here I'm sorry for my pronunciation. Just try it on your own. The name is displayed. Why am I 99% sure that this company is the manufacturer of the Radian Raptor? You will find out within this video exactly. But the main point is, the design in every single part of the Radian Raptor telescope itself matches exactly the other telescopes I own and dozens of others that are produced by them and sold under various names. To make it clear, it's completely common that one factory in Asia is producing products, and not only optical instruments, but every kind of products, and dealer or retailer all around the world are selling these products under their own name or brand. It's a fact that you will always find one manufacturer and some dozen brands offering the same or similar products. These manufacturers are called OEM, and the products sold under various brands, OEM products. OEM stands for Original Equipment Manufacturer. You might never have heard of Trevor Optical Instruments, but it's quite possible that you own one of their products or some produced by another OE manufacturer that you never have heard of. An example might be Longpeng Optics, another big player within the Asian market for telescopes. Though keep in mind, manufacturer and brand are often two completely different things, and OPT or Radian are brands. The manufacturer of the Radian Raptor is JR Optical Instruments, that produces lots of telescopes sold under different brands. So, do you like telescopes and have your own? Your own design? No problem. You might reach out to the manufacturer and choose how your own scope should be like. You choose the name, the color, the glass, and some other features. It's not 100% the fact, but you can imagine it like having a catalog and putting together some features the manufacturer presents to you. It's kind of playing with some Lego bricks, but with less freedom of choice. Mainly you get what the manufacturer provides. Just choose from the portfolio of the OE manufacturer. My brand, the name doesn't matter here, has decided for a white housing with shiny red applications. They did so some years ago.
And it needs to be all black, but not shiny black, like a matte black. I got to design my own telescope. And guess what? We did it.
This is the Radian Raptor 61 triplet refractor. This telescope has 61 millimeters of aperture with 275 millimeters of focal length and a super fast 4.5 f ratio.
If I would be rich and crazy enough, I could reach to that company, choose some specs, tell them to paint the telescope like green, and sell it as the frog, the first completely green wide field telescope, a frog with red legs. Well, that sounds strange. But then it would be designed by me and brought to you by my brand, the Red Leg Frog Scopes. Here is the Frog 61. It has 61mm aperture with 274mm focal length and is super fast, f4.5, allowing you to capture light so much faster. The Frog, the first ultra-wide field telescope, exclusively designed by Red Lag Frog Scopes.
All right, now for the main event. This is the Radian Raptor 61 triplet refractor. This telescope has 61mm of aperture with 275mm of focal length and a super fast 4.5 f ratio, allowing you to capture light so much faster than most scopes on the market.
Oh, wow. And this is the O61. This telescope has 61mm of aperture with 274mm focal length and super fast f4.5. And this is the Sharpster 61. This telescope has 61mm of aperture with 274mm focal length and super fast f4.5. And this is the THED PH261. This telescope has 61mm of aperture with 274mm focal length and super fast. Well, you got it, right? So, sorry, Mark. This is your unique scope, your epic experience.
Well, we did it for you.
And sorry, Trevor. This is the telescope that is
different than all the other options that are out there.
Well, not really. And, by the way, the Radian Raptor is a 274mm telescope, not
275,
just like all the others. But we will come to this later in detail and you will find out why Mark and Trevor call it 275 and not 274mm.
275mm of focal length.
Yeah, 275mm.
And now it's time to hear Trevor.
I got to design my own telescope. I designed the style, the name, the packaging, the design, and of course, the specs. So what makes this compact triplet APO different than all the other options that are out there? I said that it had to be compact. I said that it had to be a triplet APO, and it has to be wide, like really wide. I wanted the optics to be fast, at least f5 or below. And it has to be flat too, and I don't want to have to go around searching for the right flattener to match to it. It has to be built in. You need to be able to attach a DSLR or a mirrorless camera easily without any backspacing surprises. There needs to be somewhere where you can thread a filter inside. And it needs to be easy to mount too, and easy to mount a guide scope. And it needs to be all black with red accents. I hope you guys can appreciate the amount of time and effort we put into the design of this telescope. I designed the styles, the specs, the design, and of course, the specs. I said that it had to be a triplet APO. I said that it has to be wide, really wide. I said that it had to be fast. I said that it had to be at least f5 or below. And it has to be flat. I said that you need to be able to attach a DSLR or a mirrorless camera easily without any backspacing surprises. I said that there needs to be somewhere where you can thread a filter inside. I said that it needs to be easy to mount a guide scope. I said that it needs to be all black. And of course, I said with red accents, like one of those Canon L-series lenses. I hope you guys can appreciate the amount of time and effort we put into the design of this telescope. So what makes this compact triplet APO different than all the other options that are out there? All the other options that are out there.
And now, do you still think that Trevor has designed his own telescope? Not only the color, but any optical or technical part?
And of course, the specs.
He has designed with the shiny, unique red accent that he has chosen from the catalogue. Designed with a filter holder. Designed with an included matching flattener reducer with 55mm backspacing. Designed for mounting a DSLR and easy to mount a guiding scope. That's what he is saying, easy to mount a guide scope. Choosing from a catalog is called to design? I'm not sure on this, but just draw your own conclusions about the way Trevor has designed his own unique telescope. You will find out way more on Trevor's design process, which took him 6 months, within this video. I'm not sure if you're convinced yet, but the roles are set. Judging Rutschring Opticals produces the Radian Raptor. OPT has branded it and sells it. An Astro Backyard has the job to advertise it and bring it to the game using his range. But there has to be something special with the Radian Raptor. Or more than only something. Regarding the videos of Trevor and OPT, it seems to be kind of a game changer. It's somehow different, right? Let's hear Trevor and Mark from OPT.
So what makes this compact triplet APO different than all the other options that are out there?
Let's take a look inside this epic experience.
Okay, it's different than all the other options out there, and it is an epic experience. And why? Both give an answer. One part of this answer is
one package that gives you everything that you need to create the perfect image.
It comes with everything you need. Everything you need.
Everything that you need. Epic, epic, epic experience.
Okay, let's put it together. The Radian Raptor is different than all the other options out there, and it is an epic experience. And why? Because it comes with everything you will need, and because it's one package that gives you everything you will need. This sounds great. Doesn't it? I, as a customer, will get a telescope to start right away without caring about anything. And, as it seems, no other option out there can deliver this comfort. Let's hear what this
everything
is. Let's hear Trevor and Mark from OPT will explain. First, Mark will tell us what else is inside
one package that gives you everything that you need to create the perfect image.
You have to be a bit patient before Mark gets to the scope itself.
Let's take a look inside this epic experience.
The first 5 minutes, he announces with Werf some
bunch of other fun items
and
our killer upgrades.
We will run through this faster. The first thing that seems to overwhelm him is the paper box.
Once you get your package, you're going to find this custom beautiful black box with a quote from our dear friend Trevor Jones.
I designed, of course, the packaging.
One of the best in the biz.
A black paper box. Who cares about it? Does it take pictures? Then he talks minutes about the backpack, which is well nice, but it's too big when attached, everything included, and way too small to fit any laptop bigger than a tiny or 12 inch.
Inside the box, you're gonna find your new Radian padded camera bag. Here is where you can fit your laptop, iPad, instructional booklets, sky map, or anything flat that you want to put inside. You can also lock it down with a Velcro strap to make sure that it's secure.
And the backpack does not take pictures. Same counts for a
bunch of other fun items.
Nice, unnecessary, and none of these items take pictures or make the telescope better. All these parts are useless to astrophotography, but you should remember them, cause you pay for every single one of them.
This is a great way to save you some money. We've included a bunch of other fun items. We've included this top quality 2021 lunar magnetic calendar. We've included this top quality Radian vinyl sticker. You can peel it and stick it on anything. We've included this top quality Radian telescopes microfiber cloth. One of the best in the biz. We've included this top quality discount card. One of the best in the biz. Discount card giving you $20 off your next Radian product. This is a great way to save you some money.
This is a great way to save you some money.
The next 2 minutes, he presents the rings and the mounting plates. Both are the only parts that are really special to the Raptor. These are quite cool items, but both are not necessary and both don't take pictures or make them more pretty. Just another word to the two different fast mounting plates. The smaller V-style blade is just the standard, which is included like this or a bit longer to any telescope by JR Optics. Sometimes it might be too short to balance the equipment on the mount, but this is the standard. The Bigelow's Mandy blade is just a tiny bit longer, but it does not fit straight away to any mounting base from any astro tracker. I own 7 different astro tracker: Skywatcher, the big and the small one, Ioptron, the bigger and the smaller, Wixen astro tracker, and the Omegon Alex 2 and 3. On none of these astro trackers you can use the Bigelow's Mandy fast mounting plate straight out of the box without buying a special base. I would go for the standard V-style mounting plate for sure. Well, you can use it sometimes when you're willing to screw it fixed on your mount. But is this the way to use a fast mounting plate? Do you like to screw off your telescope after a long and cold night? I really do prefer the standard fast mounting plate the way it is designed for, fast mounting. So the Lowe's Mandy style plate can be used for some bigger pro mounts like the Skywatcher EQ6 or the Ioptron GM45. But it's only a handful. My Skywatcher EQ5 and my Ioptron CEM22 don't take it. So overall, the second plate is a nice item, but I would not miss it if not included. In his video, Mark presents now some really cool
killer upgrades we highly recommend.
But we will come to them later. First, we will continue with the Raptor itself.
This Radian Raptor 61 is the super fast 4.5 F ratio and a super fast 4.5 F ratio, allowing you to capture light so much faster than most scopes on the market.
Sorry, Mark. The Radian Raptor does not allow you to capture light so much faster. But yes, as fast as the others. And in fact, the Raptor telescope itself is an f5.5. The attachable reducer reduces to f4.5. And by the way, talk to any photographer on Earth. Everyone will tell you that f4.5 is not fast. Most will call it slow. Yes, I know, within the range of lens telescopes, there is quite no system that lets pass more light. But you cannot take the experience from visual sky observers from 30 years ago, where f4.5 might have been very fast, and take them one by one into the modern photographic world. Because within the photographic world, f4.5 is not fast, period. I use telephoto lenses with f2.0 or f2.8. This is quite fast, and with them I will sit on my computer developing my data while a photographer with an f4.5 optic will continue to capture light for some more nights to get the same signal I got with my f2.0 lens. You will have to photograph for more than 4 hours with a slow f4.5 optic to get the same signal from a faint nebula that you will capture within 1 hour with an f2.0 lens. This is fast and f4.5 isn't. Yeah, that's not fair by me. Lens telescopes are not fast at all. And if though, they are way, way more expensive. Mirror telescopes can be fast and kinda cheap. But you cannot call an f4.5 optic super fast. Period. Ask any photographer.
I'm fast as fuck, boy. Still fast as fuck, boy.
Yeah, it's not fair. But do you, Mark, care about being fair or even honest in your video?
275 millimeters of focal length.
Yeah, 275 millimeters.
That ensures you have the perfect stars from corner to corner. It's because, well, we did it for you.
And here comes something I found kinda strange. On nearly every telescope you will find within the specs which kind of glass is used, because the glass is one of the most important things for image quality. Check it out on your own. You will find, for example, the really good FPL 51 or the even better FPL 53. Quite every telescope will tell it within the specs. Of course it will be told to you because it's a main feature, maybe the most important.
We made sure that we had the most premium glass that we could find to give you the best color correction and contrast in your image.
Have you heard? a premium class. So I went to the OPT webpage and checked the specs. Nowhere to find which class is used. This is very unusual. Normally the class would be pointed out on the first place, especially when it is a premium class. To be fair, I'm sure they used the best FPL53 because this is what the manufacturer, JR Optic, usually uses. Or the cheaper FPL51, which is also in their lineup. But I don't think so, because then you would not call it the
most premium glass that we could find.
But who knows, the specs don't give an answer. And the term premium class is not copyrighted and it could be used for FPL53 as well as the cheaper FPL51, which is a great class as well. I don't know, maybe it's just the bottom of a Coke bottle, but I don't know. Before we will continue with Trevor and Mark, I will show you one of my telescopes. One of these 61mm aperture 274mm focal length super fast f4.5 telescopes. Here it is. All the parts I will show you now will pop up in the videos of OPT and Trevor. Many of them as special features. So pay attention. There is a reason for every part I will show you in that detail. First, this is the telescope itself, and attached to it, this is the reducer flattener. The reducer flattener gives you a 55mm backspacing, as common, so you have not to think about backspacing at all and can attach a DSLR, a mirrorless or an astrocam quite simple. That's standard and nothing special.
Inside is a built-in but removable match flattener with a 0.83 reducer. One of the struggles astrophotographers go through is finding the perfect flattener and reducer that ensures you have the perfect stars from corner to corner. We made sure that you don't need to go on the hunt, and every order comes with the perfect combination right out of the box.
Yes, you're right, Mark. Some astrophotographers have trouble finding the right reducer flattener and the right backspacing. But not with telescopes from Trevor Optics. They deliver always the reducer flattener with a 55mm backspacing, as they are doing with the Sharpstar, the TS, my brand and the Radian Raptor. Nothing special so far, but good standard. So not you at OPT have
made sure that you don't need to go on the hunt.
It is a standard service by Trevor Telescopes. Don't decorate yourself with foreign laurels.
Now, something about the back focus section that you should know is that it's exactly 55mm, which is perfect for ZWO, DSLR, and mirrorless cameras. There's no need to look for the perfect spacings because, well, we did it for you.
And no, Mark, again, not you at OPT did this for us. The manufacturer produced the perfect backspacing. Don't take the credit of some other company's efforts. You can find this like on every of these JR Optics telescopes, 55mm standard. Nothing special on the Radian Raptor at all. But Mark again wants to decorate OPT with a false feather and dress themselves in bird plums. Normally, when your telescope is delivered, you will find two boxes. One contains the telescope itself, which in this case has a focal length of 335mm, and the other contains the flattener reducer. This part reduces the telescope with these lenses inside from 335mm f5.5 to 274mm f4.5 and allows you to take flat images. But the telescope itself, of course, stays a 335mm telescope, only reduced to 274. And exactly the same counts for the Radian Raptor. But didn't OPT and Trevor told us that the flattener reducer is a fixed part of the Radian Raptor telescope?
The right flattener has to be built in.
Inside is a built-in flattener with a 0.83 reducer.
My first guess after watching Trevor's video was that the flattener reducer really is a fixed part of the telescope.
It has to be built in.
The manufacturer has other telescopes in its lineup with a really fixed, included and not removable flattener. But after watching the OPT clip, I knew that it is not a part of the telescope, which proved true finally after receiving my own Radian Raptor. In reality, it's the same flattener reducer with all the 61mm OEM scopes. Normally, when such a telescope is delivered, you will screw off this part, the so-called visual back part, and screw on the flattener reducer. You will keep it screwed on as long as you want to take pictures. But if you want to take a visual look, for example on birds or the moon, you might unscrew it and switch back to the visual back part. The visual back part is a standard included part which comes with every telescope I ever had and of which I know of. I've never seen a telescope without it. OPT might has a trained ape at the company shop that screws it on for you, though they can sell it as fixed included flattener reducer. I don't know. And I don't care if the flattener reducer or the visual back part is mounted on that scope. I don't care if the one or the other is delivered in an extra box. It doesn't matter. But here comes the first of many points that made me kind of angry and produces the feeling that OPT want to fool customers somehow. And this is Mark's killer upgrade number one. Before we look at this, please remember.
Everything that you need.
Everything you need.
Everything.
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 So Mark, your comment on everything?
Now before we get to the telescope itself, let's touch upon two of our killer upgrades.
Great, but before we start with this killer upgrade, I will show you all of my telescopes. Or to make it clear, I will show you the visual back part that came with every single one of them. Because it's standard that the visual back part is included with a telescope. Here, here, and here on lens telescopes. And here on my Newtonian telescopes. And here on a 20-year-old lens telescope. Yeah. As I said, the visual back part is absolutely standard. It has to be dismounted or screwed off to use a telescope for photography. And it has to be reattached if it should be used visually.
Now before we get to the telescope itself, let's touch upon two of our killer upgrades we highly recommend. The first killer upgrade is this visual back piece that allows you to use your telescope as a visual scope with an eyepiece, or remove the reducer to turn it into a pretty wicked guide scope. This is a great way to save you some money.
Because I always get that part wrong.
Now draw your own clue, or just follow me. First, OPT and Trevor told us the flattener reducer is a fixed part to the Raptor. In reality, it's not. It's just screwed on and not in an extra box. It's the same flattener reducer as always. And that's no problem so far. But instead of putting the standard part, this visual back part, into the backpack where enough space would be, they sell it as
a killer upgrade
for $40. And this with a telescope that
comes with everything you need.
Everything.
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 But you get the postcard with the $20 off code.
This is a great way to save you some money.
Yes, or it's a great way for OPT to make more money.
Because I always get that part wrong.
Remember, it's included with every telescope I ever saw and with literally every telescope from that manufacturer, but not with the Raptor. While the Raptor is the most expensive one, which costs way more than similar scopes from that manufacturer, a standard part is missing and only available as a killer upgrade for $40. And this is not the only standard item that is missing. A really important one, especially for astrophotography, is missing as well. We will come to this later. Now I would like to switch back to my telescope in the Radian Raptor, but it takes some time before Mark finally gets to the presentation of the Radian Raptor itself. Because after advertising these more or less useless items like the sticker, he has a second
killer upgrade.
This second killer upgrade is a simple USB focuser. A normal price range for a good USB focuser would be around $150 to $250, maybe $300. And not for an Asian online store where you might buy a nasty brick of unknown origin.
Oh fuck! Oh yeah!
But for good standard quality straight from ZWO. The ZWO USB focuser. Look here, $200. And track the specs and take a look. It works with the ASI Air, of course. Let's listen to Mark.
The next killer upgrade that I highly recommend will always give you pinpoint stars throughout the night. It's our factory-tuned Radian electronic focuser. One of the best in the biz. It's Radian Raptor ready, and you're ready to rock. Keep in mind, it does need a computer or external program to run it.
Great. So far, I have no doubt that this focuser will perform good. And maybe even better as the $200 one from ZWO, which is of course solid, but not outstanding. Let's take a look on the OPT's webpage how much this focuser is. Oh yeah, $500, that's quite not such a cheap killer upgrade. But in fact, it is an upgrade compared to the missing killer upgrade visual backport, which should be included. But why should I pay $500? And furthermore, it seems, but I'm not sure on this, that the Radian Raptor is just a rebranded Optech focuser. According to the Astro forums, you will need to install the Optech software to get it to work properly. Okay, the Optech is called to be an outstanding focuser, but then this killer upgrade is not new, and it is an absolutely overkill for a little 274mm telescope that normally sits on an astro tracker without any computer control at all. You don't sell a beginner level bike for $500 and highly recommend an additional bell for $300. But to be fair, it's still an upgrade. Oh, and by the way, have you seen this? Not compatible with the ASI Air. Okay, I don't use it, I have a better and cheaper solution for me, but some of you will. Here is an example of the Raptor with the ASI Air and the ZWO focuser, which fits perfect to that telescope's focus knob. For me, this really doesn't make any sense. The Raptor fits perfect to people with an astro tracker and the ASI Air. Small, portable and affordable equipment. How does a $500 focuser matches to this target group?
I think this is a very pivotal telescope. It sits in that spot between the people that are nightscapers into deep sky astrophotographers.
There's another item in the OPT store I found. You could call it the third killer upgrade. They don't mention it here in the video and it has no direct connection to the Raptor. But it is really freaky and it will turn out so funny that I really would like to include it here. But it's so time consuming that I placed it as an add-on or kind of a hidden track on the end of this video. So we will get back to Mark and back to the comparison of the Raptor and my 61mm scope. Inside the flattener reducer, you will find a place to set in a 2-inch filter. More than one scope by JR Optics that I own or know of has this filter holder. But it is sometimes not even mentioned in the specs, and in real life it doesn't work that well. So it's part of the current standard design by this manufacturer, but nobody talks about it. It is not advertised. Mainly, I guess, because it doesn't work that well.
Now this part's pretty cool. We have a built-in filter vault. If you carefully unscrew the backspacing section, we have threads on the inside for a 2-inch filter. Just screw in your filter and put back the backspacing section.
Hey, that's pretty good.
No, it's not. The built-in filter box is part of two of my JR Optic telescopes. But I didn't knew of it a long time because it is not advertised or mentioned in the specs. And guess what? I tried it. It's absolutely a pain to use. Everything but handy and not fun to screw in a filter as long as you are not a child with tiny fingers. Did you see how they cut out the video right when Mark starts to screw in the filter? Guess why? It's a pain to screw it in and a bigger pain to screw it out.
Screw in your filter and put back the backspacing section.
Oh, wait, we have to stop here. Have you seen the sticker? Take a closer look. 274 millimeters. Did you realize that Mark and Trevor always talk about 275 millimeters?
275 millimeters of focal length.
275 millimeters.
And did you realize that all the similar products by JR Optics are announced with 274? So why do Mark and Trevor call it
with 275 millimeters?
Because it does sound somehow nicer? Or to be unique? Or maybe it's just a trick, though, that the customer does not realize too fast that the Radian Raptor is just a clone of all these 274mm scopes. I don't know, but the sticker is clear, 274mm.
Right here.
And now let's take another, the final look on my wide 61mm scope. The four parts I will show you now are the ones I would call the most important in connection to the Raptor and in connection to the videos of Trevor and OPT. So please pay attention. This here is the focuser, the normal knob for faster focusing on the one side and the same but with an inserted 1-10 fine focusing knob on the other. Here you can see the rack where the focuser runs in, a common and stable design. Great for finding the perfect focus. The screw on the bottom of the scope fixes the focus. And here you have the rotator. The rotator is a part of the telescope itself, of course, and not a part of the flattener reducer. It also had the screw to fix and secure it in place after you rotated your camera matching your target into your field of view. And here you can, but not should, loosen some screws and use or misuse the reducer flattener as a rotator as well. It is not the telescope's rotator, which is this part, but you might do so, what I would not recommend, because it is not the rotator. If you have really, really bad luck, you will screw off the reducer flattener and drop your camera. It works if you are careful, but it is not meant for that. Better use the dedicated rotator. And as another standard part, these telescopes are delivered with one stable 5cm wide ring and a handle to carry or mount accessories, like I did with this Arca Swiss fast mounting plate, to use it on a photographic tripod, ball head or on one of my astro trackers. And here you will find the mounting shoe for a guiding scope. This is a necessary part that comes with all the telescopes by this manufacturer. It is the common and easy way to mount a guiding scope, because the mounting plate for a guide scope has a fixed international size. So you can mount your guide scope fast and dismount it as well within seconds after a long and cold night. I never ever had a telescope without a shoe for a guiding scope. That's it. That's quite all. A normal telescope with a normal visual backport, a normal mounting shoe for a guide scope, a normal flattener reducer with the common standard 55mm backspacing and the filter holder, a normal focuser with a fine focuser and a normal rotator. Everything absolutely standard on every telescope I know of made by this company, JR Optical Systems. What I personally like the most on this telescope? The unique shiny red accents. And, by the way, these telescopes come of course with a retractable dew shield and a front and a back cap to protect the lenses from dust and scratches. After this, back to Mark and the Raptor.
This is also built with a full frame image circle, so any camera with a full frame sensor or smaller works perfectly.
No, Mark, you don't have perfect stars from corner to corner with a full frame camera. Trevor is fair enough to point this out. Okay, in fact, Mark from OPT is just telling that
so any camera with a full frame sensor or smaller works perfectly.
Mark is not saying perfect stars from corner to corner, but the way he talks might let the customer think so.
So any camera with a full frame sensor works perfectly.
And I'm sure it is intentional to let the customer think so. Why? Listen to Mark some minutes before.
One of the struggles astrophotographers go through is finding the perfect flattener and reducer that ensures you have the perfect stars from corner to corner. Perfect stars from corner to corner. We made sure that every order comes with the perfect combination right out of the box.
In fact, you will get a dark stripe on the bottom of each DSLR full frame image, which of course can be corrected with matching flat frames and is not annoying. And on full-frame sensors, the stars in the corners do show some coma, astigmatism and colorful halos known as chromatic aberrations. But as said, the Radian Raptor is a good telescope with a solid image quality, at least in the center. And that's fine, and no one can expect more with such mass-produced telescopes. But I can expect an advertisement video, to be honest. In here, it doesn't seem so. Here are three examples from the first three nights, raw and only that white balance in Lightroom. It might be possible, and it's quite likely, that using some very small extension rings would help to get better stars. But then it's just like with most scopes, going around and searching for the perfect backspacing within millimeter ranges.
And it has to be flat too, and I don't want to have to go around searching for the right flattener to match to it. It has to be built in. You need to be able to attach a DSLR or a mirrorless camera easily without any backspacing surprises. If you are shooting with those smaller sensors, it will be completely flat to the very edges of the field. On my full frame sensor, at the very edges, you can just see some elongated stars just coming out, some coma at the very edges. Very demanding on the optical system to have that full frame sensor. You could just crop it in maybe 5-10% and you have a totally flat image. But I thought it was important that I point that out.
And by the way, I do know how to use my bad enough focus mask. The next parts that Trevor and Mark point out are the focuser and the rotator. And this doesn't look, though, good for our leading designer, Trevor.
Something I was adamant about in the design was the focuser. It had to be super high quality. So it's got the focuser knob on the one side and then the fine focuser on the other, the 10 to 1.
We've included a dual speed fine action focuser.
No, Mark, again, not you have included it. It's standard. And no, Trevor, it's not your design. It's the absolute standard by Trevor Optics.
This knob is for large coarse adjustments, and this knob is for finer adjustments.
And it's super smooth, but it's also very secure. And you can, of course, lock it into place with the screw on the top here. And you can, of course, lock it into place with the screw on the top here. And you can, of course, lock it into place with the screw on the top here. Because I always get that part wrong.
Look in the camera back for the included focus lock screw and screw that in right here. This is going to adjust the tension of your focuser and lock it down once you find the perfect focus. Screw that in right here.
Lock it into place with the screw on the top here.
Right here.
Thank you, because I always get that part wrong. I got to design my own telescope. Something I was adamant about in the design, I've been using the Raptor 61 in my backyard for the past 3 weeks, because I always get that part wrong.
And Trevor, did you really use this telescope for some nights and never fix the focuser? As Mark showed, the focuser is fixed by the screw on the bottom.
Right here.
Not only with the Radian Raptor, but with many scopes. And it is not fixed with the screw you're pointing at.
With the screw on the top here.
I thought you have designed it. Didn't you tell us something I was adamant in the designing was the focuser?
Something I was adamant about in the design was the focuser.
So you were adamant with the designing, Trevor? Really? You have designed it, but you don't know how and which screw is used to fix the focuser?
Lock it into place with the screw on the top here.
Hey, what a fantastic designer. And by the way, exactly the same counts for the rotator, which you confuse with the flattener as well as you confuse the screws.
In this same component here, there's some screws that you can adjust the tension of, and that's the rotators.
Seriously, what the f*** are you doing?
In this same component here, there's some screws that you can adjust the tension of, and that's the rotator.
As I said earlier, you can use the flattener reducer as a rotator, but it is the flattener reducer and not the rotator of the telescope. If you have really bad luck, you screw off half the part of the reducer flattener and drop your camera on the ground. There is a reason that the telescope itself has an included rotator and a screw to fix and secure it in place, while the rotating part of the flattener reducer has none.
In this same component here, there's some screws that you can adjust the tension of, and that's the rotator.
But maybe, Trevor, you couldn't use the real rotator and though did not realize that it exists because you mounted the scope in such a strange way. Instead of using the small V-style fast mounting blade, you screwed it fixed onto your astro tracker. Why?
You might have noticed that I've got that heavy-duty Losmondy-style dovetail mount on the telescope. I really like that. It's a bit overkill for this setup, but I just love that plate.
Trevor, it really looks like you have never used the real rotator, right? Did you ever realize that it even exists over all your nights with the Radian Raptor? And after 6 months of design process? Or did you record this video before the first image, right after receiving the Sharpstar the Raptor straight out of China? This would explain how you can confuse nearly every part of the telescope. And please, don't tell us that you have a prototype and more great stuff is coming with the original.
I think most of you will appreciate that it comes with two more surprises and options that I don't have on this prototype edition.
Trevor, you have the original. It's the original OEM product as it always have been. And it's absolutely identical to mine, which I bought over 6 months later.
This scope also comes with both a back cap, a lens cap, and a retractable dew shield.
Oh wow, Mark, this is absolutely killer. The Raptor comes with a back cap and a front cap as well. That's awesome. No other company ever came up with this idea. So I don't know for what I admire OPT more. For the idea of putting a front and the back cap to the telescope, or for the idea to include a $20 off code and
a Radian vinyl sticker.
But I think for the price of the Radian Raptor, I can expect both. Because, as you will find out, you will have to pay over $300 or over 550 euro for these items.
This is a great way to save you some money.
There's a final part I would like to show you. Besides that visual back part that should come with every telescope and has to be bought as a $50 killer upgrade, there's something else missing, which is always a part of a telescope and absolutely necessary. A finer shoe for mounting a guide scope. That's absolutely important, and Trevor knows that.
And it needs to be easy to mount too, and easy to mount a guide scope. And easy to mount a guide scope.
But hey Trevor, why is there no mounting option for a guide scope included with the Radian Raptor? And why does Trevor use a mounting option, likely the one from William Optics, that is not included to show how easy it is? And why is it included with every other telescope I own? Maybe just because...
It comes with everything you need.
And why has it been so complicated to mount a guide scope that there are videos on YouTube about this issue? Look here, how to mount a guide scope on the Radian Raptor. Why, Trevor? Oh, why?
Trying to figure out how I was going to mount a guide scope to this and realize that I'm not the only one having that problem. So I thought I would show how I did mine. And hopefully that would help some folks out, since there seems to be some confusion about how to, what a good way to get this done.
Look at this video. This guy has found a way to mount the guide scope, something that seems to confuse more people regarding the astroforums. He has screwed the finder scope fix onto the Raptor. But is screwing on the way you want it? And can you place it into the backpack that came with the Radian Raptor after a long and cold astronaut while the autoguider is still screwed on top? Normally, this should be done with the guider's fast mounting plate that sits inside a guiding shoe, exactly as Trevor does with the William Optics mounting handle. Why is it not included while every other telescope includes it? I think you all already know the answer.
Everything that you need.
Everything you need.
Everything.
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 So let's come to a conclusion. First, the telescope is not made by OPT, and it's of course not made by them, specially made for us.
Well, we did it for you.
I have not found any technical difference or a better build quality compared to the other telescope I own, and I can't see a better image quality as well. So I cannot believe that they have put lots of
time and effort
in the technical and optical
design of this telescope.
As said, it's a good solid telescope with all these little issues that these telescopes have. Quality control isn't that strict on mass-produced OEM products. But you get what you pay for, at least most of the time. Don't expect a thick $1,000 telescope when paying $700 for a Sharpstar or $1,000 for the similar Raptor. And of course, this is not designed by Trevor as they want us to believe. It's just one of some dozen telescopes made by JR Optical Instruments. There are similar scopes on the market and with the Sharpstar 61 version 2 quite exactly the same. I only can say quite the same because I know that the Sharpstar 61 uses FPL 53 class, while the Radian Raptor does not mention the type of class within the specs. But they talk about premium class, so I'm quite sure it has to be the FPL 53 as well, as it is the best the manufacturer uses. Everything else couldn't be called premium. Or could it? Beside the glass, which I just can assume, everything else is the same. The dew shield, the rotator, the focus, the 55mm backspacing, and yes, the shiny red applications. And yes, the front and the back cap. And of course, the unhandy, more or less useless filter holder. Everything absolutely standard, everything the same. Though the telescopes themselves, the Sharpstar 61 and the Raptor 61, are the same. And this also counts for the TS and my brand, at least for the most part. And to point this out again, all these have 274mm focal length, not 275, not one of them, not the Radian Raptor.
So what makes this compact triplet APO different than all the other options that are out there?
There's absolutely nothing unique on this Radian Raptor on this telescope itself. Not a single bit. Mainly it's the black color and the not so unique shiny red applications.
And it needs to be all black with red accents.
And also not the name.
I design, and of course, the name.
Remember the Radian Raptor charging handle from the beginning?
So here we have the original Raptor. You can go back in my videos and see for years.
Quite nothing is unique. Okay, the accessories are different. One of the two mounting plates is in fact an extra, but only useful with a handful bigger pro mounts and quite useless for some astro trackers without special additional items. As said, you can screw it fixed on your astro tracker, but then your telescope is fixed screwed on your tracker, as shown in Travis' videos. And this is not the sense or the meaning of a fast mounting plate. You will like to take off your scope after one night without screwing small screws off. Then there are the nice rings, which unfortunately once opened here accidentally, but they are indeed an extra as well. The backpack is nice, but it does not take pictures or can fit any of my laptop. But it is indeed the third real extra. Then there's the sticker and the $20 off code. On the other side, while you get these upgrades, the backpack, the rings, the second plate, the sticker and so on, the shoe or another mounting option for a guide scope is missing, as well as the visual back part is missing. But you can buy these for around $60 to $80 or €80 to €100. The visual back part as
killer
a
killer upgrade, we highly recommend.
So finally, you will have to pay $1,000 or 1,350 euro for OPT's Radian Raptor. The Sharpster 61 is for 800 euro or $650 to $700. So you add over 50% of the Sharpster price in dollar or over 65% in euro on top to get the Raptor. And all of them include such fancy items as the front and the back cap. But the Sharpstar and similars all of course have the included OPT's killer upgrade, the visual back part, and the necessary shoe for taking a guide scope which is missing at OPT's Raptor. So you will have to pay $300 or 550 euros extra, which of course is
a great way to save you some money.
This is a great way to save you some money.
You will pay this for the nice rings, one nice mounting plate, and the photographic useless items, the backpack, the sticker, the $20 off code, and the more useless stuff. And on top, you will add another $80 or 100 euro for the normally included visual back part on the mount for a guiding scope. And with this in mind, the Raptor nearly doubles the price of the Sharpstar, the TS, and the brand I use. This really is
a great way to save you some money.
This is a great way to save you some money.
So, why should you buy this telescope? Because it's matte black and has these shiny red parts? Because of the $20 off postcard? Or because it was designed by Trevor? The best reason might be that you like to pay more for an already existing product with a new color and some nice but unnecessary parts, which is presented to you through an influencing infotainment campaign. Please do yourself a favor and watch again the complete clips by Trevor and OPT and keep this video here in mind. I'm sure you will realize how much both, but Mark from OPT a bit more, are taking standard parts of a standard telescope and redefine them as something special. I'm sure you will realize how they don't inform you, but advertise an overpriced product. And you will realize how much both want to take the credit on themselves for a pre-designed OEM product. And take a look at Trevor, how he handles a telescope that was designed by him as he wants you to believe. Take a look how he misuses the screws and confuses different parts of that telescope. And maybe you will be aware that he never talks about or uses the real telescope's rotator, which he maybe has not discovered after 6 months of designing and within all the nights he has used the Raptor. Okay, there is this one scene. Look here, he's randomly touching some screws, also the screw for the real rotator for the first time. But for no reason. This was clearly shot only for this campaign, and none of his moves makes any sense. And, by the way, where is the
easy to mount a guide scope
in this scene? Okay, to be fair, it's very unlikely, but all this just might be mistakes within a video. But the amount of misconceptions and confusions don't make me believe that Trevor ever took any part in the actual optical or technical design of that scope. And it makes me think that Trevor might have captured this video where he states,
"I've been using the Raptor 61 in my backyard for the past 3 weeks."
Before he ever used the telescope at all, right after receiving the package out of China. Because if he had used it, he had figured out which part actually is the rotator.
And that's the rotator.
And for what which of the screws is used for.
You can of course lock it into place with the screw on the top here.
If he had used the scope before, he wouldn't call the wrong screw the focuser screw, and he would not call the flattener reducer the telescope's rotator. Not after using it for some nights, not after 6 months of designing process. And to go one step further and be even more fair to Trevor, all this could only be mistakes while recording the video. But afterwards, while editing the video, he should have found these errors by himself. At least as he would know of these misinterpretations and confusions. And as a last chance for Trevor, before uploading a video to YouTube, one normally does track it a last time for major mistakes. And it seems that he was convinced that everything was right. Sorry, I just cannot believe that one can fuse a screw that holds the focuser in place after 6 months of designing and weeks of use. Same counts for the rotator. This is beyond my imagination. And I can't believe that Trevor is telling on the one hand it comes with everything you need, and on the other he accidentally uses a not delivered mounting handle for the guider to prove his statement that it is easy to mount a guide scope. Way too many strange coincidences with this 274 millimeters telescope. I for myself feel like Trevor and OPT want to fool me, meaning they want my money for any price. This feeling popped out from the very first moment I saw Trevor's video, but intensified, and it became stronger after my Radian Raptor was delivered, and after I realized that they literally want to sell me an 800 euro Sharpstar for 1350 euro, which means 550 euro extra, and have the nerve not to include neither a mounting option for a guide scope nor the visual back part, but selling it as a killer upgrade for another 50 euro, I really was pissed. And finally, the phrase "everything included." The missing part, especially the missing mounting shoe for a guide scope, made me angry. All these empty phrases about the extraordinary parts that are in fact all absolutely standard, and the recurring statement "we have done this for you" made me make this video.
Well, we did it for you.
I don't like to get fooled, and I hate such faked influencing campaigns. I will take corrections if I was wrong in some of my main points, but I'm quite sure that I made a clip which delivers a straight line of evidence and kind of proof that the Radian Raptor is not a special telescope in any way, but a scope which is very overhyped and overpriced. It is an outstanding good example how influencers raise their voice and use their range to sell all kinds of stuff to their followers. To make it clear, Trevor is not selling rubbish. It's a solid telescope, but he is still advertising an overpriced product. And he still is, and this is the most annoying part, not honest with you. He's not honest about the missing mounting option for a guide scope, but takes a maybe William optics instead of in his video. He's not honest on the design process. He's not honest on his part, the part as an advertiser, influencer, poster boy, not as a designer. He never ever designed this telescope. How can you and why should you trust Trevor in any of his statements on products?
And I'll feel partly responsible for that because of this Raptor 61.
Do you know what? I'm kind of disappointed. In fact, I liked Trevor. I liked the positive way he encourages beginners to start with this hobby. More than once, he found the right words to show how much fun astrophotography is and that it's not about having the biggest telescope, but about the right mindset and about the love exploring the night. And therefore I'm disappointed and annoyed. It's not about testing products, not even about sometimes getting paid for that. That's the way YouTube works. And it's not about making mistakes. That's human. We all do. It's about an advertising concept selling a mass telescope to fans with lies. These lies are not mistakes. It's the concept. The lies are intentionally implemented. The Radian Raptor only works with these lies as a product. And this annoys me. This disappoints me. Because I like Trevor, I like the way he encourages beginners with positive vibes, at least in the past. So, if you like a wide field telescope, you will be happy with any of these JR Optical Instruments telescopes. No matter if it is branded as TS, Omegon, Sharpstar, or any other brand you will find. You might be happy as well with the Radian Raptor, just because it's identical. So, no doubt on image quality, but think twice if it has to be the Radian Raptor or if you would be happy with one of the similar ones for way less money. $300 or €550 are kind of a high price for the rings, the Losmandy blade, the backpack, and of course the sticker and the $20 off code. And remember, you will add another 60, 80 or 100 to get the additional back part and a bracket to mount a guide scope. And as a last statement, I would not be surprised if they, OPT and Trevor, would come up with another Radian telescope, the Radian 76 or the Radian 94, announcing the next Sharpstar clone with these words: "After the overwhelming, incredible success of our 275mm Radian Raptor 61 and the awesome images that you all have taken with the R61, we are so proud that Trevor again designed another scope. Here is the Raptor 76, or here is the Raptor 95. If so, I'm ready, because here I have the RJ Optic 76, a super fast f4.5 triplet APO with 342mm focal length, a telescope with a lower price as the Radian Raptor 61, but you will get much more telescope for your money. So stay tuned, and please,
if you guys like this Raptor rundown, give it a like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications.
Or don't do it, because normally I'm doing videos in German. But you might like some of my time-lapse clips. Feel free to click here. Or, if you want to, you can spend the last 5 minutes on OPT's real killer upgrade I mentioned at the beginning. In any case, thanks for watching. And now, grab yourself any telescope, travel under dark skies, and enjoy the precious hours under the stars. Because
astrophotography is too important to sell.
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 And now let's take a look on OPT's real killer upgrade. Look at this laser on Alibaba. Or on this, or on that. Or on all the others. It's always the same. And so is the price. Around $3 with an included charger. Compare the design. They all look exactly equal. The rings, the riffled surface, the key on the back, and the flat part to print a brand name on it. Every part on every laser is the same. They are the same. Cheap Chinese OEM products. You can find them on eBay as well, but the price has tripled, around $10. Let's switch to Wikipedia for 1 second and check the regularities on laser pointers around the world. Lasers are sorted into classes, mainly depending on the power. And you know why. Lasers can harm your eyes, blind you, or even burn stuff within seconds. Some countries allow lasers up to 1 milliwatts, others even up to 5 milliwatts. Stronger lasers are considered as harmful in nearly every country around the world. The legal classes are mainly class 2 and 3 R and B. Here are some examples that show that 1 to 5 milliwatts are the legal range. Australia, Canada, the Netherlands, Switzerland, the United Kingdom and the EU, and some more. Within the USA, it's kind of complicated, but basically, it's the same. Legal laser pointers are up to 5 milliwatts. And now check out this killer laser by OPT. $65. And please read this. 100 milliwatts laser. Remember, 1 to 5 milliwatts is the legal range in most countries around the world. So a 100 milliwatts laser really is a killer upgrade. At least for your eyes. Wouldn't this logo from that eBay laser be a better choice? I don't know what happened there. Did OPT purchase a cheap $1 laser out of China and never check the laws? Or did they just copy and paste some wrong data? 100 milliwatts? No way, and absolutely illegal. And it will not become legal when selling it for $65 instead of $10. But it gives me some strange feelings about OPT's price politics the third time within minutes. How could you sell a $1 China laser for $65?
This is a great way to save you some money.
Maybe this laser is as unique and special, just like the Radian Raptor telescope. Let's check the description. As with any Radian product, the green laser is made from premium quality components and comes with everything you need to start using it. Oh man, this sounds so familiar. Haven't I heard this before? Premium quality? Everything you need to start?
We made sure that we had the most premium everything that you need that we could find.
Premium quality? I don't trust OPT in any of their words. This isn't a premium product. They try to sell us, the customers, a cheap China laser as a premium Radian product for $65. A $1 China laser that you can get on eBay for $10. The premium Radian laser is a clone, a fake, a simple Chinese OEM product. And the lie. And so is the Radian Raptor telescope. A clone, a fake, a Chinese mass-produced OEM product, presented with lies using a false influencing campaign on YouTube. And that's it. All done and dusted.
And then you're ready to rock.